Today we're going to make a little video of my process for making hearts and various different sculptures. I've always talked about how I use recycled materials in order to make the things. I pick up wood from various places in the hills, dumpsters, from tree trimmers, wherever I can get it, and then make it into something that's beautiful and just enhancing Mother Nature's already beautiful work. And today we're going to make a heart. Here's a picture of one that we're going to imitate. This is a 5-inch heart. It's 5 inches wide, 5 inches high, and I've done the fractal burning on it. And this one isn't finished yet, but it would have a finish with probably a gold inlay in the burning. So let's start with picking out a piece of wood out of my little wood scrap pile here. Let's see what we can find here. I've got lots of different woods, as you can see. I pick up some of it out of the mountains. Some of it is off fall from a cabinet man that makes beautiful countertops and things, pieces that he's going to throw away. And I look at each piece and I see a beautiful piece of something that we can manufacture and make into a nice piece that would enhance somebody's wall, hanging on their wall or sitting on their counter. Let's look through it and see what we've got. Got all different kinds of wood in here. There's poplar, there's birch, there's, here's a nice piece. There's a nice piece of walnut. That'll be big enough. We could probably get 2 hearts out of that. So let's take that around to my shop and we'll get started, okay? I'm going to take the next step, which is we need to trace the heart. I want to try and get 2 pieces out of this beautiful piece of walnut. It looks a little bit rough, but I can see that there's some beautiful grain in it. So we're going to make the first piece here. And I think that will give us enough, yes. That'll be just right to get 2 pieces. Okay, let's take this to the bandsaw for the next step. Here we're on the bandsaw. We've cut these pieces out. Step, because both sides are very, very rough, I take it onto a belt sander and I flatten them out. But this one I try to capture the dust because it's very dusty. We're going to turn the dust collector on again, and we're going to use the oscillating drum sander in order to sand the outside edges. out these outside edges nice and smooth, and you'll see why when I take it to the next step, which is on the table saw, so this can ride flat on the table, and the sanded sides on these sides will sit tight against the fence. Let's go to the saw. On this process, this is a very dangerous process, and I do not recommend it. Do not try this at home type of thing. I have worked with it for many, many years, all my life, and so I try to keep my hand completely away from the blade. But this is how I rough in the piece of material. We won't do it on this one, but we actually take and cut it three different times. Okay, we first cut that I made on the angle was a 45. I'll make two more. One will be at 30, and the other one will be at, and the last one will be at 15. So let's do the 30-inch cut now. And I have to adjust the fence so that I get the right amount of cut off of the fence. This is the main step to where you shape the heart and actually get the rounding and the balance of two sides and the whole thing. This is done with a strap sander. Get the right way. Put it in the vise, then start freehanding the rounding.
go.
That's beautiful.
That is really neat.
Will stick better and it's not so hard on the hand. Now we go back to this, to the vise, and using a finish sander. Dust this off and check and make sure we got all the scratches out of it. If we have to touch it up, the scratches, we'll do that. And then we go on to the next step, which is the fractional burning. Okay, this is the next step that we're going to put in the what's called fractional burning. Or Lichtenberg, and we use electricity for this. We've taken a transformer out of an old microwave, and we have stepped it up from 110 household. This steps it up to 2,000 volts. So this is dangerous. If you don't know what you're doing, don't attempt this. Learn how to do this off of the internet. So we'll go ahead and turn this heart into that. The first thing we have to do is wet the wood. Wood is a non-conductor of electricity, so we have to saturate the wood good with water and baking soda. Just plain old house use cooking baking soda. And it'll take a little bit of time to soak that in. Just kind of keep soaking it for a minute or two. And you put the solution, where you want the burn to go. If you don't put the solution on it, the burn usually won't travel to that area. You don't have a lot of control of where it's going to go, but you take one electrode and put it on one side of the board, and the other electrode, put these gloves on as a little added protection. I don't want to get shocked with this. I've set this up so that I can see when it's on, if the light will light up, and I have a switch here, and I turn it on, and it will start to burn. It dries out, so that looks pretty good. The next step is to clean it. Take a brush and brush the soot out of all of the burn areas. We have to let it dry, and then we have to touch sand it again because the water raises the grain on the wood, and then we're ready for the finishing process. We can stain it different colors, we can take the fractal and paint gold paint, blue paint, anything we want in it, or leave it just as it is. A lot of people just like that black burn and with a nice light stain, and then three or four coats of lacquer finish, and we've got it done. One last thing that we have to do is put a hanger hole in the back. Just round that off, kind of finish it off. There we go. Small little nail in the wall, and you can hang it up and have a heart forever.